Good, how are you?
So another week, huh?
Yep.
All right. So do you do this with all the churches?
I mean, all the churches. There's 150 in the county. I've been to 8.
Yeah.
Okay. I came here because I was at Atascadero Bible Church and a lot of people were against me. Or I was at the high school and a lot of people were against me. And Christian people, they're pro-life, they're Christian. So originally I came here to just present myself, do what I'm doing down there here while parents are there and they can come talk to me.
Yeah.
And then from the response, I thought, well, it's not that they don't have the opportunity to talk. They don't want to talk.
So nobody comes over and talks to you?
Not very many. I mean, not as many. I mean, more yelled at me out the window at the high school than come talk to me here.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I just...
So, is that why you're here, is to give parents from the high school an opportunity to talk to you, or...?
Well, that's why I originally came. Now I just felt like I should come back and just be, you know, be here. Maybe people would warm up and come talk and see what we're saying.
Yeah.
First day I handed out a bunch of stuff, but, you know, got the trash can there.
Right.
Not really encouraging. And that's the issue at the high school. We're bringing the gospel, we're bringing this. And, you know, the Christian principles against us, the Christian pro-life people are against us, and the kids are going, well, what do I believe?
Yeah.
Here's these Christians over here that are against this guy, and he has the gospel, and he's telling us that abortion is wrong, and they're just stuck in the middle. I'm just going, oh.
Do you think they're against your message, or do you think they're against the way you present your message?
Well, I guess that would be for them to decide.
Yeah.
What they want to say or do. I don't know that there's a difference. I mean, as a Christian, I want to know the truth. Some of the guys screaming and yelling on the street, I don't necessarily like that, but what's the guy saying?
Yeah.
Should I listen? You know?
Yeah.
I don't know. Is he dressed? You know, how is he dressed? I don't know. I don't know that there's a difference. So, as a Christian, that's how I would view
right.
it.
Because
what's the message?
I mean, I know the principal.
Yeah.
I know the principal at the high school.
Yeah.
And I know he's not for abortion. I know he's against abortion. I don't know that he knows you enough to know whether he's against you or not. And when I've talked to him, it's more he's not against the message, it's the way the message is presented. You know, it's like, for me, like with the things that you're handing out and with some of these pictures and stuff, you know, I just feel bad for, you know, a 6, 7, 8-year-old kid come walking in here and seeing what looks like their baby doll all bloody and stuff, you
right.
know, and
yeah.
how is that going to encourage them to do something positive, you know?
Sure.
That's always been my concern, even about the handouts and about the billboards and stuff, you know. Do you feel like Atascadero Bible Church isn't doing enough, or?
That's a question every Christian has to answer themselves.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I'm not the judge, and I don't know. I know that I don't see anyone really fighting against abortion. We support the local plant CPC. We support, you know, adoption. We do those things, but
mm-hmm.
to stand up and actually fight against abortion, do something to, like, say this is bad and wrong publicly and decry it and
yeah.
say that, you know, they're murdering kids, you know, at Rite Aid, Albertsons, wherever, and then 15 minutes from here surgically they rip them apart,
right?
And it's like, what are we doing to actually stop that? I don't know, and I'm not the judge.
Yeah.
It could be that you're doing absolutely everything you can, and it could be that everyone in your church is also doing everything they can. In my estimation, I think, well, what if everybody here is doing everything they can, wouldn't they be like, woohoo, good job, I'm glad you're doing it because we can't, you know, I don't know, wouldn't they agree? Or they park their cars so I can't be close, you know? It's like, well, huh, we can mobilize and we can do something against, they don't want me here, so they're gonna mobilize, plan ahead and do something against me. Well, what about something God hates and says the never thought of child sacrifice never entered his mind and he hates it? And and we live at peace with it. We have blood on our hands, and And he hates our worship, and he hates our praise, and he hates those things because we have blood guilt. We're bloody, you know? So,
I mean, we certainly, you know, every time, you know, if we're preaching and the text is, you know, speaks to it, we speak to it, nobody's running around it, we certainly let everybody know, you know, what our stance is, what, you know, what we believe, we do, like you said, a lot of the positive things, the you know, foster care, adoption, we encourage that. We have a lot of families involved in that, and that's been a new thing. You know, we've really gotten more and more involved in that, Tree of Life and stuff like that, trying to have a positive impact and encourage people to, you know, carry their babies into term and to, you know, have, you know, even if they can't, they're going to adopt, you know, do adoption, and then make sure our people are there to adopt, and making sure our people are there to take kids out of the foster care system and do things, you know, and support them in ways that we can. Certainly the student ministries is more involved in, you know, when they're teaching, you know, teaching against abortion and you know, the sanctity of life and doing those things more than even we would be in the worship center.
I get, you know, the card, I got the card, the yellow card, and it said, "We oppose abortion" on the top. And I thought that came to my head was, I think the armies of Israel opposed Goliath too. But they don't tell us about the armies of Israel standing there for 40 years and David coming. It's like, hey, he believed God and he went and he did something about it, right?
Right.
And it's not even about David. It's about the Lord willing to work in his servant, whoever that might be. And again, I don't have any stones to throw. I feel like we are a nation covered in blood, a Christian's covered in blood, and the Lord's coming back to, we're not gonna be able to stand before him and wonder whether we did enough. He's gonna be exposed.
Yeah.
And we'll all know whether we did enough. And my prayer, if anything happens at your church, is maybe the Holy Spirit moving somebody or moving a group or moving people to say, are we doing all that we can?
Yeah.
Answer the question, not before Danny, before God. And if you are, the Bible tells us we have confidence to stand before God if our consciences don't convict us. So, I feel, I love people and I love Christians. I feel like I have been apathetic in my life towards abortion. I sat in the pews my whole life. I'm 36, abortion's been legal my whole life. And 56 million of my neighbors have been murdered and I haven't treated it. I haven't cared for it as I think God cares for it. And I think the Bible says this battle is not against flesh and blood, and I think the spiritual ramifications of abortion are far worse than even the physical. 56 million dead is the tip of the iceberg in relation to, I think, the spiritual aspect of abortion. And my hope is that people will turn to the Lord and repent and fight the spiritual battle.
Right.
I'm repenting of my apathy. I'm giving myself to whatever the Lord asked me to do, and my prayer is that others will too, if they haven't already.
Yeah.
So.
Well, you know, I don't know if any of the other guys have told you, you're always more than welcome. If you don't think we're doing enough, you're more than welcome to come and talk to our elders and talk to the leadership and say, hey, here's what I believe God's put on my heart. I think all believers, including Atascadero Bible Church, is apathetic and not doing enough to stop abortion. And again, I don't think no one here is going to argue with, you know, your message.
Right.
You know, it's just, is this the best way to reach the most people, to mobilize them to you know, be more active in stopping abortion.
Is your view, if I cut you off, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Try not to do that. Did I cut you off?
No.
Okay. Is your view, see, one of the things that I'm battling against constantly is the idea that how many people are responding to what I'm doing, like, and are they agreeing with me? I'm not looking at that.
Right.
And I'm trying to, you know, other guy, which everyone's been nice that's come talk to me at your church, which I'm thankful for because it's not always that way. But
let me know if they're not.
Yeah.
Let me know who it is that's not, and we'll, you know,
they've all been very nice. So
we tell everybody, you know, he's doing what God calls him to do.
The other guy, he's like, how do you measure this effectiveness? And I was like, I have no idea how to measure the effectiveness. I don't know that biblically I can go, that there's any justification for measuring effectiveness. It's to obey and to go and do. And I mean, there's no doubt, like, there's no doubt that as far as effectiveness, even if people are angry, you know, if you told the people that are angry, well, there's an effect. And,
yeah.
And I've been angry before and come around after thought. I think the Holy Spirit laid me and said, you know what, I was wrong and I should agree with that position. Not that they were right, but...
Yeah.
And I hope, I mean, this is one thing I tell people too, is like, I'm not saying I'm doing it right. I didn't come, you know, I don't come here hoping that you'll follow me. I'm hoping that you'll lead. I'm hoping that you'll say, this is wrong. This is how we're going to effectively fight abortion.
Mm-hmm.
Great. I'll follow. If I believe it's biblical, I'll follow. Okay, this is wrong. Let's do that because that's going to win.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to bring glory to God. So, you know, I don't know if that makes sense, but...
Yeah, I mean, it would seem like the way... If you want to mobilize this church or any church...
Yeah.
To be more active in stopping abortion, it wouldn't be to come and put signs on the sidewalk. It would be to come to the church leadership and say, hey, how can I come alongside you guys to help you mobilize to stop abortion?
Uh-huh.
And, you know, we would certainly welcome that. Whether they would do anything, I don't know. I'm not an elder. I don't make those decisions, whether they would do anything.
So you're telling me that a better approach would be first to come to the elders and say, I would like to speak to you.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so I can make an appointment with them.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can come and speak to them. Uh-huh. And tell them what I want to say.
Uh-huh.
Okay. All right. I'll do that.
Yeah.
I'll try it.
Okay. Yeah, they're, you know, like I say, we're, and they may tell you, no, we're going to keep doing just what we're doing, but at least you'll know.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Where they're at. And so, you know, it's just, like I said, you know, we tell people, you know, Danny's out there doing what God called me, he feels God's calling me to do.
How's
it
go
when you're at the clinics?
Fine. I mean, well, I guess I don't know what you mean.
Are any of the women receptive? How do the clinics handle you?
The clinics ignore us. The people there are some receptive, some not. I've seen a few women change their mind.
Uh-huh.
It's always. The Lord changes their mind and we're just there to talk to them after. And it's awesome. And it's like, the message for me there is like, it's all God's work. We're just standing there to collect and see it. And it's like joy. So anyways, I've seen that. A lot of people don't like us being there, but it's cool. And there's fellowship, which is really cool too. Not with believers.
Yeah.
It's like some believers are coming there and they're having a hard day and we're fellowshipping there as we're witnessing and trying to help plead with people and stuff.
Yeah.
So is there somebody
down there all the time or
no? There's Thursdays is the day they do surgical abortions.
Okay.
And the rest of the days they do chemical and hormonal abortions and then birth control and stuff. So one of the goals would be to have people there 24 hours as long as they're open. Not 24 hours. As long as they're open, every hour they're open, have people
right.
there. Because everybody going there needs the gospel.